super deep right now. Jerry actually might be able to see him. Oh man,
what is going on?
Oh, they're both seeing each other. Okay, Jerry maybe thought.
Control has been gathered. Wow, Flit is all the way into spawn. Oh my god, this is such a weird round, man. Now Chopper's dead in the back. This has gone horribly wrong for Spirit. They are not getting any fair fights. They're not even looking at these people, and they're just dying.
Yeah, this round was all over the place. Dex are only full strategy.
Oh, that's hard to say because Forza play in a pretty weird way. Just variance, I guess, would be the way to put it in the way they play sometimes.
Yeah, I feel like they have a few more options here, and they'll be making their way up catwalk. Spirit is actually already almost completely rotated in. Dexter finds his second, make it third deagle, scout kill of the round now. And Flit actually, they kind of lost their identity and used this like 4-1 style where Flit's just on the other side of the map. And it didn't really work out for them. And I'll hold that thought as they are just flooding out of A right now. Chopper has so much to do and Flit just instantly takes him down. This was just an all out A rush and Forza have come out on top.
Nate exchange, both pretty much dead on for either side. Two players taken down to half health, but how likely is this retake from Spirit?
Has the skill to make that entry work look good. I would say that it's between him and Jerry usually for who's the most mechanically talented as a rifler, but we'll...
Flit's got that AWP in his hands, but I'm not sure if he'll be straying into the open anytime soon. It might be Voltaire who goes in first. He spotted that boost, forced them away, but he doesn't realize Chopper is also in connector. That is three Spirit players focused on mid, something that Forza weren't ready for.
Yeah, now Murr, oh, he finds the timing on Flit. Flit wasn't sure what angle he had to be holding in that position, and Murr is able to capitalize. Now Almazer will make his way onto that A site with Jerry now, and that is not a great smoke, but it doesn't matter. Almazer is able to take down Magix, and that might be a blessing in disguise, actually. Jerry's trying to play around it now, but he's unable to find anything just yet. They knew about his position, and Jerry is able to come up with a great kill onto Patsy. Murr is able to take down Jerry in return, which leaves Almazer in the 1v2 position. He is usually one of the more clutch players from Forza. Let's see what he's able to get done. Jiggles out one, but Chopper goes for the swing and takes him down. Spirit are up 4-2.
I'm definitely intrigued to see if Spirit continue to play...
And Flit, he's actually made his way up connector. Oh man, I don't think Spirit's going to expect this. This might be a free stab in the back here as Chopper is here towards window. And Flit, he should get the better of him, but does he want more? Oh man, Flit, what is this? Is he going to let him go? Okay, finally takes down that player and he's able to get Dexter on top of that. 2v3, and despite Flit doing so much in this round, it doesn't feel like they were ready for him to get those kills.
Ooh, Magic's in an awkward spot on the A site. Flit's able to clear him out. Now the bomb should be about to get onto the A bomb site. Flit is still going aggressive though, still looking for kills. He's gonna get another man in the back. Flit with four on the round. In a good position to deal with this. You've got to assume that Mir isn't gonna be able to clear out all these spots. Flit caught off guard early, but Onkare is just gonna bide his time. He knows Mir has to come in and clear these angles, and Mir does have a look, but he doesn't get the shot.
Forza didn't really have a shot in that round.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, the bomb is towards spawn. Onkare has to make sure he doesn't lose this. Either way, Spirit are going to have a heavy stack on the A site with all this information gathered.
Yeah, that's really quite nice. But oh, Patsy finally thinks it's time for him to push. But Onkare was there and waiting. Now, this might force the hand of Chopper as well. And things are looking so good for Spirit. But for an A hit, this is really interesting. And Dexter's actually made his way into Palace. This is such a pivotal position on the round. The tag comes out. Magix actually spots Waro 2K. And then Dexter is in just such a great position to find that kill. But it's still down to a 2v2. And Flit doing massive damage from Balcony there, leaving just Magix with the scout. And at this point, he needs to find the shot through the smoke to have a real opportunity. But the bomb is indeed planted. Goes up on top of Ticket Booth. Can't find the kill. Does it get tagged? But he actually takes down Waro 2K. And Flit, on top of default, is trying to find this. Jerry's just holding. And he might be able to catch a player off if they push a little bit too far. This angle is rarely...
Now, Chopper is playing towards stairs, so he can have a look, but Dexter has rotated away from the A site, and that is leaving A so susceptible to a push right now. Blitz coming in for the flank. The timing is just right, and now Dexter has to do something for his team here. He's got the first kill, but then much here. Mir is taking so much time. I don't know if they can go for this. They've realized they have to call this off. The save will be coming through. Blitz may even try and take too much damage, though. And we don't get an early kill yet.
Looks like Forza will be going for a little bit of a late mid control. There are two players coming from underpass right now. Is there anyone to support them from top up mid though? Doesn't look like that'll be the case. Chopper's able to get Almazer for free. Onker with a great trade, but Dexter is in fact holding that swing and he activate Onker. But if Jiri dies here, this round is lost for Forza.
Here comes Onker. Jiri will be waiting for him to make a move. Oh, never mind. Jiri's dead. So that's not worked out for them. Onker is just now getting into ladder room. And as he said, this round is lost at A, but they haven't committed off the back of them just yet. Chopper playing this angle towards Palace. That smoke's going to fade soon. So he's got to reposition slightly.
Forza don't have any more nades.
Yeah, no, they
don't. I don't know how they're supposed to re-exec to get into this bomb site at this point. They have one flash, but Woro is just going to be going for the dry peek out ramp now. And I mean, if he wins this fight, credit to him, and he does. He takes down Magix, which just leaves Chopper. But this is still so tough to get into this A site. If you can't smoke off a single angle here, it is nearly impossible. And the actual counter flash coming out from Dexter was perfect to support Woro. And at this point, this is where it just becomes impossible for Forza. There's no real avenue to find entrance into this site now, unless you find every kill. And Flit has been doing that regardless of the situation. Now on care,
some other players to step up.
Yeah, Chopper first to contest, and he'll actually fall off of the angle. Magix is behind triple right now. He hasn't had a hot game just yet, but he needs to do something if they want to win this round. But he gets deleted by Almazer. Great shot from him through the box. And actually, Chopper might have an angle here. I think he can see the leg just barely. No, he cannot, actually. So 5v4 post-plant situation, and there are a lot of nades for Spirit right now. But Flit is on the huge flank from Catwalk right now, able to take down one, looking for more. He actually gets the lineup, but Jiri from the
team for Dexter. I would love to see Dexter getting that AWP out as soon as possible to see more of what he is capable of. Right now it's Onker jump peeking, and he will spot the first man. That means that Woro has the chance to pull the trigger, and a missed molly is never good on the pistol round. You don't have many nades to work with. You can't be missing them, but the B push about to come in either way. Flip finally missing some shots, but now Mazer is sitting at bench. Surely this is an angle they won't expect. Mir actually gets the kill.
Regardless.
You don't see CTs using that top mid smoke much anymore, but Forza use it in this round. It's much more difficult to use it with the wider choke point, and they haven't really decided to commit much off the back of it. Oh no, Mir with a double entry. The lineup is the last thing Forza wanted in that round, but Mir will take it all day long. And he's another player who is very skilled. I wouldn't be surprised if
DY or Magix showed up, but a lot of the times it was Mir that was carrying them across the finish line. And then you would get the occasion who takes him down, and it doesn't look like Spirit want any piece of what Forza is brewing or baking in Palace.
Well, there we go. Baking with Maui and Hawker will not be a show coming to you anytime soon. Palace Strike will be, though. We've got Flip pushed up in the apartments. I always love playing. Oh, maybe. Jiri is now running through mid, but there's no rotate from B, and that flashbang is fantastic. Onker is a bit under pressure, decides to pull the trigger. 9 seconds. Where is the bomb plot? Well, it's not happening because Jerry's coming.
They're undoing. Forza, though, those opening picks were really the story of that round, but that broke down so awkwardly for Spirit at the end. And it's not going to actually confuse Forza very much, but maybe we don't have to.
Flit is the man playing on Cat right now. I've seen him be very hit or miss from this position. No smokes in to cover him off, and he's already got the first kill. There's a follow-up. It's three for Flit. The Org is just easily out-aiming every single player who peeks him. But finally, Spirit trade him out. That is 30 kills now for Flit, though, and he may have been the difference maker in this round. Almeza sitting back, waiting for the fight to come to him, and Dexter has... Forza, still no rotate for them. Almeza will be the first point of call. Flit will then be behind him. But how do they peek this angle? Do they time it right? The apartments player's going first. There's the kill for Almeza. Mir's still close by, but he's not able to peek. He decides to play safe.
We're still at middle. He hasn't actually rotated in yet. Every player from Forza is coming from market right now, and they have so much utility. They can molly a lot of these angles out, can smoke things off, but Mir will try to fight into the choke point. Does get taken down by Almazer, but oh, wow, Jerry actually just standing in the middle of the doorway does meet his demise at the hands of Magic's, and now Chopper and Magic's are-
Mistake there when he tried to reposition to the site. You can see why he'd do that. He was worried about getting peeked from both of those angles from Kitchen, which can be really hard to hold. And he actually delivered the AK onto the site as well. So it worked out nicely, and that's worked out nicely for Dexter, holding the angle
to the head of Dexter, but still no kill, and they needed something there. They needed something out of a fight like that. And if they don't get anything soon, Spirit should be able to convert this with their double man advantage.
Ooh, nice shot from Mip. Normally the aggro rifler on the team on Care, almost transferring for a third kill. Dexter, incredibly low on health. On Care decides to drop.
Flit decides to go for the full-on investment. I don't mind it too much if he's able to just save that weapon or just win the round with it, but Almazer, he's being pinned from so many angles right now. There's a player in Palace, but that player cannot help him at all, so Almazer has to do everything by himself. He hits a single bullet into the shoulder of Chopper, but that is nowhere near good enough to take him down. And now Waro, he's making his way up underpass at this
bomb going fairly quickly. And it looks like Forza are sticking around, but probably going for the save call. Waro even has an AK, which could be saved now. And, oh, Jerry was hoping to get another one out of the hands of Patsy. That will not be allowed, though. Patsy backing away. Waro, who has been a little quiet. I think it's fair to say Dexter has been getting by far the better of the two AWPers so far.
Yeah, Dexter has been looking real solid. They're here. There's no one to help Almazer, and if Spirit decide to go towards B, and it looks like they will, he's going to be all on his lonesome. He's got to do everything right now. Molly there at his feet, and he's taken out immediately. Dexter is able to find that kill, and now Flit, he knows that pushing out is such a high risk right now that he doesn't decide to do it, but his hesitation costs him as Patsy takes him down, and this was a two-man advantage for Forza that it doesn't even look like they will be able to get in the bomb site on at this point. Waro, is he going to take the challenge against Dexter? He doesn't actually need to as that flash comes out, but Patsy's holding this door in such a solid fashion that there's really no way that Forza can get into this one. They have to give up here, and Waro team Spirit there, Dexter on 15k, and Mir ends up buying himself all of his not the best money management given that Dexter will be on 16k moving forward, but we'll move past that as it's going to be a fast play towards A, and Mir already finds an opener.
Flashes were out from Magic's there at ramp, the ones that land towards the top of the palace, really strong flashes to flash a lot of those angles on the A site, and Mir makes the most of it. Oh, shoulder spotted, but Mir doesn't want that fight. He's going to continue to sneak up to maybe try and get an exit kill or two. I don't think Forza will allow it. They're already backing on up, except for Flit, who's sticking around, and that costs him his life. Now Forza could really do with saving the rest of these guns to be in a good spot for the next round.
Yeah, it looks like Spirit will be able to clean up the majority of these players. Almazer just holding on with this AWP in apartments right now, and there's not a lot for him. Absolutely not. There is just no way that you could save any money moving into a round like this, but they'll actually still be able to
on this position right now. The rotate is just now coming in towards CT, but the smoke goes down to Batcon just as he peeks through it. Nice timing window to try and get a kill onto the site. A long, long time for Spirit to get this bomb towards the site. Finally, though, Dexter will be the man to punch in the digits. fakes it out the first time. Flit being baited in by this. Are they watching it? It doesn't matter. He's going to get the bomb planted. And with Onkare finding one kill, Forza want to stick around for this retake attempt. Maybe that kill changes it, though. Dexter denies Onkare. Shadow spotted. Another kill from Chopper. And Almazer, he's still here. He's landing in the fight. Oh, it's finally come his way, but it's not looking good for him. He has to back away.
Yeah, unable to find anything from there. And you just hope that he turns the corner and peeks over the ledge at one point, because he probably would have found a shot, but he's going to get another opportunity here along with Almazer. Although Almazer is quick to fall at Carr, Woro can't find anything else. Murr with the double entry onto the site leaves just Jerry and Onkare, and they will be greeted by SDY, the man that is substituted back in, and he will get one, but Onkare, he still has an opportunity here. Picks up a flash and a kit, and now he's making his way up towards Elbow. Patsy has actually chosen the lower angle right now, and Onkare with a great shot actually is able to take him down. Now Chopper actually missing the first couple of bullets. Singular player in Dexter. And now Jerry, he wants to keep getting aggressive. Murr might jump up onto Xbox, and here we go. The floodgates are open, and Forza is all over middle right now, taking down every player, leaving just Chopper, and Onkare is there to take him down as well.
It's like that, right? That's almost reminiscent of a Mirage, where we just have a massive fight in the mid, everyone coming into play. Patsy eventually landing enough body shots to get that first kill onto Almazer. Flip seeing what he can do with the Deeg, also spamming to the chest. These players not really looking for the one-taps with the Deeg right now. They're happy to go for the body shots, but this time, Flip connects with the headshot.
It's probably the one time he didn't need a headshot, actually, after he bagged him. Now, SDY and Murr will try to make something happen, but Woro, well, Murr will find a shot. 3v1. A bomb plant wouldn't be too bad, actually. But Murr actually wants more. He picks up the AK, goes for the duel onto Jerry. He knows there's a player towards CT now because that nade came from there, and he's able to take down Flit. 1v1 situation, but he doesn't know the position of
Onkare. He's fake flying, thinking Onkare could be close by. That gives a bit more time for Onkare to begin the rotation. And the information is now given away. He knows it's B. He spotted it. Mir goes back to the box. Here comes the flashbang. Mir dodges away from it. Onkare coming in through the doors, or is he? He's still sitting back for now, but Mir just waiting patiently, and he ends up winning.
This time around, Spirit, they'll just run right into this B site. They know that there's a player towards Closet, and SDY is able to take him down. Flit is able to recover with a single kill, but they are already locked out of this B bomb site. Although, Woro has actually killed the player in tunnels very swiftly, and the spray through smoke connects. He's able to take down Chopper as well, and Patsy just pushes through window, and all of a sudden, Forza may be getting outmaneuvered entirely, although the bomb is still on this B site. Do they know that Almazer is here? They do.
They do now. Pat's fast B split. It could be brutal for Forza.
They will try to make this a little bit easier, but him falling actually just really opens things up for Spirit here. They have so many options. Onkare is the only player here to defend, and he's not even able to get one. Forza will kill, and taking the bomb site seems pretty unlikely for a B defense, but that is in fact the case. And
Forza are a bit further back. Oh, Patsy, I'm not sure he'll expect this on top of blue. Yes, he goes out. He's not ready for the double peak, so they only lose the one player. But with the AWP here, he's actually not going to have an easy time on the hold. The Molly's burning it down to 36, but he still lands the first shot either way. Second kill not going to come through, though. Patsy able to trade, and now that A plant should be coming through, but Almazer gets an all-important kill. He's crunching them in from the back, trying to make life difficult, and he's got another one. Patsy gets his second of the round, but now they're kind of trapped on the site, fighting their way out of it into the 1v1. Patsy needed the ace, but Flit is the man to close it out. But they've lost A long, and Jerry's out in the open.
Oh, that flash, though, might set Jerry up. He sets himself up, but Dexter still gets a blind kill on top of it. And Patsy is there to take the form as well. There are two players here, and Spirit's hesitation may cost them in this round. Woro's able to find one. Flit falls to SDY, and SDY continues on forward, taking down Woro, leaving Onkare here towards CT. The jiggles come out from Chopper, and there's nothing.
So spot towards Car where you can fall back quickly and have more impact later in the round. In this one, Warro's got the scout out though, and he nearly got a 2k. Oh. He does get a 2k through the door, and this stack towards the B site on the rotate is looking fantastic. Not a single kill for Spirit in that
round. A lot of the time, teams will just do that very haphazardly, but Spirit have actually looked really good in those kinds of situations, but now they may have given Forza. As the opening pick goes the way of Forza, and now Warro, he's rotating towards middle. It'll be an op-on-op duel, and Dexter gets the better of Warro. That's how it's been all series, and it continues and synthesizes in that duel there, leaving just Flit towards this B site.
Actually, get into position. Oh, the Molly sound. They know he's here. They've got to know that he's run through that. Oh. Another Molly deployed, and Flit is now in a spot.
No way.
They don't know, Maui. Oh, the lineup. Flit gets them all. The transfer is so sick.
Or is it even an inch, because they can take absolutely everything away. I can't believe it. Is coming from. His visualization skills are just really top-notch in this series, and I'm sure it's going to be even easier for Spirit given that entry that Murr was just able to accomplish. But Jerry, actually, still at long, is able to find one. But okay, Murr
is starting to move in from that flanking position. He's actually keeping Forza locked in. They can't save comfortably. Well, they can now. Onkei gets, and then Mir just gets a second entry. He's really good in those opening fights. Mir loves to play as that entry man, the point man for Spirit. That because they've got plenty of players on long. Mir on short has to be very careful here. Down to 9 health, but he waits patiently. And Almeza falls forwards. What is that from Warro though? He's just got 2 for the price of 1. Dexter able to trade him out though into a 3v3 on this A site.
Oh, bomb trying to be planted. Flit gets boosted up, but SDY actually recovers the situation, able to take down that player. And now Dexter is holding the smoke so close, but he can't find the shot. Onkara is able to take Dexter, and SDY in the 1v2 has to come up with the headshots. He does not do that, and Jerry is able to take him down. That puts a 6th round on the board for Forza there, and I just want to know what happened there at long. With Warro finding that collateral 2k, I feel like that right then and there.
About the last round, I can't, because we are getting some early action in this one. Oh, wow, where's Warro? He's just pushed lower tunnels. He's got that early kill. Spirit will go for the long control. Now they've lost B, but Miz got the 2 headshots. He heard. He must be heard.
Surely.
No, no.
Okay, Murr is able to recover the situation. Actually, box in Spirit towards long. The number advantage still lies with Spirit, but if Flit's able to get even one more kill here, this may be enough, as now Onkara strikes on the flank. He's been activated, but he only finds the one kill. So Spirit...
half. We've been having a lot of very impressive performances so far, and Mir already gets his first of the second half, spamming to the back, and Forza remaining static, but Onkara's about to spot these players in the tons, and Almeza runs him down.
Yeah, able to escape, but Dexter is actually able to find Flit towards mid. Have to take a little bit of damage or take a fight to get there, but it looks like actually Almazer was able to get onto that position, but that is exactly what I'm talking about. Onkara tries to follow his lead, but he gets taken out because of it.
Warro fighting aggressively. He actually gets a kill alongside Almeza, who now drops down into CT for this clutch attempt. He has to take this fight. He goes out wide. He almost gets the kill, but Chopper is able to secure the round with the headshot. That is Spirit going up 10-6. But with this bomb plant, Forza may have some options either in this next round or maybe...
if you want to have a clean flush smoke for the cross, but... it might not even come to fruition, because Dexter is taking out everybody with this scout. 2 headshots from him early on, and there is that singular smoke, but you will see that there is indeed a big gap in it.
No shots taken on that gap, though. Chopper sneaking onto the site instead. How sneaky can he be here? How cheeky? What? My game just froze, so I don't know what's going on.
He got him. He got him in the smoke. Onkara and Jerry, they're trying to make something happen in this 2v2 now. And, oh, Onkara with the double spray down to close it out. Forza are able to win that one. I'm really surprised that Forza were able to...
Phase. Dexter had the clear line of sight, but it's Patsy there.
Needs go out towards CT spawn. a lot of pressure on Amur and SDY. And Dexter actually through the smoke is able to take down Jerry. That is a huge help. And Chomper actually pushes out long at this point, leaving Onkyr stuck towards middle right now. They may have an idea that he's here. Cassie seems to be keyed in on the angle, but Onkyr actually hits the shot, and he actually gets Dexter as well. 3v5 situation. There's no way that he should be winning this one, and he won't.
For both teams, we've got the AWPs, we've got the full nades. We've got no excuses for either side, and wow, Dexter actually pre-aims that angle perfectly. Waro2k was waiting. Little did he know that Dexter was about to peek him, and oh, another chance given to Dexter. The AWP has been recovered by Almeza. He is seeing if he can take the fight, but elsewhere, Onkyr with a quick snap to the head, and we're back to a 3v3 after the trades, but the A site is pretty open right now. The bomb is far away, though. They're going to have to run boost across to the site more than likely. Oh, Onkyr, the first man to go. Another headshot. Onkyr.
They get it across. And now, Dexter, he will push on forward. That scope may have been heard, but it was probably... yeah, the most important round for them in this game. If they had lost this one, things would early control taken here, but they will be met by the AWP of Dexter. If they flash him off this angle, that could be everything, but they don't even wait for the flash. Flit actually just dies for free right
there. I feel like you need Onkyr to do something here with that position he's gained. Otherwise, it's just the mid play, and the counter flash is absolutely perfect. Mir gets that kill. Finally, Onkyr's position comes into play. That's the A site wide open, and Spirit are pretty far away from this one. It's a 2v4, but maybe Fools have given themselves a chance. Issue is, the post plant is not going to be easy.
Now, Jerry, he has to do so much work at this position. There's no one to help him out at all, but the flames actually work to his advantage.
Oh,
peeking right behind it, and Onkyr is able to get two kills in that situation. SDY, he has to come up with everything, but Jerry and Onkyr do absolutely... even when it shouldn't be, they are still getting it done. And so Dexter will take a very advantageous position, but it actually doesn't work out. So many rounds where it just feels like one player dies and they lose this entire bomb site. And I don't, at this...
no. You lose that first fight and the site quickly, you're in trouble. As you're playing close to window, here's them, but Onkyr is just landing everything right now. Oh, another headshot for Onkyr. Mir lines up a couple of kills, but the CTs lose almost... ooh, Onkyr runs around the side. Jerry able to trade him. The run boost over the top works out for Fools. A one-for-one trade on that play. Flit maybe thinking about doing something silly here, but he has decided to fall back, which is the wise call. Waro's got another kill, though. SDY picked off on mid. Now Mir has to go into the smoke. Mir is playing a very risky game right now, but he gets aggressive, and they've got nades out. First kill is good. The push is coming in from A long as well, so now they're forced into lower tunnels, and Mir gets him in the back. Flit finally getting the trade up close, and the second kill. 20 seconds on time. I don't know if he's got this. It's going to be incredibly close. He goes for the fight. Flit's got it. He drops it to CT to win the...
needed as he wins the 1v3. That's just unbelievable.
Oh, bro, Dexter tried to peek through them.
They've still got a little bit of fight in them. Mur, he was able to break open that last round, but it won't happen this time. Almazer takes him down, and the cat hit is being called out by Onkyr. He continues to deliver in this game, one kill shy of 30, and it looks like we will be moving to map number 3 as Waro takes... did he learn from his mistakes? Oh no, it was actually the other game. Never mind, about taking the silencer off. Well, won't even matter, as Mur is able to take him down immediately. And actually, this is complete control taken by Spirit on this B site.
There is a kit in play for Forza, but this retake remains difficult, especially with these shots landing. SDY just goes aggressive, and that...
difficult to incorporate the one new player, but I mean, again, I gotta try to give credit to Spirit here, but I'll hold my applause as actually it's Forza who's coming out on top in this round. They found so many picks early on, and it just leaves SDY in a 1v4 situation. And Waro in the side of his head. Forza is given that Forza is still working with the scout and that MP9.
Smoke from Waro in connector that lands in towards Brown Halls, but doesn't that smoke that Jerry was playing behind? But now that it's faded, it's a two-man stack, and Jerry, I think he jumped there. That did not look great. Now it's a 3v5.
Woro dropped his scout. Okay, P250. He's able to get one, but that was a very good half. And it looks like it will come to bite them as they push on forward using that MP9 at the beginning of this round. And that was a play that if they just had the M4, they wouldn't have made that. They would have played standard and probably been able to secure this one, or at least had a better chance. But Flit, he's going to be called out by Magix there, who is holding the angle.
It's likely to be tested early in the round, but Moro is the first rotator, the first responder, and he is going to be required to do something here because Onkaz makes this retake from Fools really difficult.
Yeah, the utility is actually still pretty good for Forza. They could smoke upper and lower if they so choose, and they have a Molotov on top of that to maybe molly in front of or behind one of the smokes that they throw. But getting up close is really the difficult part of this. And Flit is able to take down Chopper. That's a big frag. But Magix, he's still up close and personal now. But he's in a 1v2 already. Woro took out that other player, but Magix continues. He takes down Woro. It's just down to Almazer, who's right on top of him at this point. And Magix breaks it all down. A nice three-piece from a flash in just a second. I think Chopper will be flashing Murr into this position. Oh no, he actually flashes over T-Con, but it doesn't matter. Murr is able to take down Almazer, and the trades come out in favor of Spirit at this point. There's nothing to work with on the side of utility. And Forza having to try to just fight every angle at once. This is just a complete dismantling of the A site from Spirit. Onkaz will try to make something happen, but he gets caught as well. Very well played round, as well as you should. The CT side is all about getting that full money, because once you do, you have so many options, but that works. Flash comes on the side of Forza. It's just so hard to imagine a way that they get back into this one cleanly.
And again, you've got Magix moving into enemy lines, this similar position where he delivered in that previous round. Oh, and he's done it again. First shot is connected. Magix moving into the smoke, potentially wanting to do even more. Dexton gets a kill from the site, and there is the stab in from the back. Magix delivers it, and I think that's probably a good bit of success on both sides of the map right now, in all honesty.
Yeah, 7-3, and Forza there just attempting that opening kill in the previous round. They weren't able to convert. And now this round, it does look like it will be a fast A play from the side of Spirit. Murr's already able to take down one. Jiri does find a return with that saved weapon. But oh, a miss spray from Murr there actually allows Flit an opportunity to recover his gun after getting that kill. And Dexter, did he just shoot through the legs of that opponent? I don't know how that could have missed. And this is somehow working out in favor of Forza. Or maybe I spoke too soon, as it's now a 2v2.
Moro's going to peek round the side with the scout, and he gets the time.
Do, because now that he throws the smoke, and it doesn't look like there's a great opportunity for him to find any sort of position, and Woro just... Almazer has to come up huge, and now it looks like he's been spotted. They're all keying in onto his position, and Magix is able to take him down, and Magix, with some great movement, some great positioning, is actually able to give his team a lot more information, but Jiri actually pushes through the six smoke, and he's only able to find the one. It leaves Onker, and just Onker, in a 1v3, and there is so little for him to do here. He just has to find instant headshots. That's a good start, as he takes down Chopper, but there's still so much ground for him to cover. The Molly is good in that it will prevent that player from peeking out of Top Dog, but there's just still too many angles.
Lucky to be alive there on 3 HP. He's the one man with the AWP in this round. He's already taken a ton of damage. Almazer with the scout, unfortunately, only able to land the tag. If that was an AWP, he'd get the kill, but not meant to be. The weaker by caustic. Now Woro is out in the open. He's going to get caught. Spirit just pressuring all over the map.
This is so swift from Spirit. They are just flying down Ivy. As soon as they got that kill on Almazer, they didn't even hesitate for a millisecond. They just ran all the way through. And what is this? Jiri getting shot at from behind, and okay, finally turns around. He tags SDY, but yeah, Forza, they're just losing so much ground. They've lost everything at this point. Onker and actually Flit do connect with a couple of kills, so there is an opportunity here all of a sudden. But this position from Flit, it's very strong, but it's tough to hold on to, especially if he comes up the ladder. There's just no way. And SDY takes him down.
One care, that's close to a kill. Eventually gets it, but obviously the A site is now where he needs to divert his attention to. Well, more likely the player in connector who's just going to kill him outright.
It more or less is one. It's and it'll be an aggressive play. Okay, Woro right in the faces, but there we go. They go for the force, and that's just one of the few options you have as a CT side. You just have to get aggressive with the MP9s. You have to try to take space away from them. It was a gamble, and I respect them for trying to make it, but they're met by bullets in their faces.
Yeah, disheartening if you are a Fools fan right now. It's going to be double digits for Spirit. And considering this is the T side of Train, Spirit have already done more than enough on this first half. Jerry seeing if he can maybe save a gun. He's actually got two smokes to try and just see if he can get up here and maybe get away with something. Flit looking for the nade lad. He goes down. Jerry also follows. So no save guns for Fours. Just whatever they can buy for the last round of the half.
Yeah, even though they're going to be upgrading in this round, probably, it's nice to keep the armor at the very least. It'll give you that extra little piece of utility. I mean, $650 is nothing to scoff at. And
from that Molly at Ivy. That's the start he wanted. Ooh, Chopper's been able to get an opening for Spirit, though. That's much more like it for Woro staying dynamic. That flick down is fast onto Mir, the man who is furthest forward. And now that Jerry's got another kill, that could be the stabilizing factor that Fools needed. Woro's still going. He's got a second. Now Mazer trying to play this off angle. Magix almost goes down, but he survives on a slither of health into the 3v2. Here comes SDY, though. Easy tap, but Jerry's there for the trade. It's just fights all the time, but it's Magix about to back on up into On Care, and it is five rounds.
Every play that they so choose seemed to work out, and Forza, I can't say the same, but maybe this P250 will work out for Woro. He gets one. Nice trade from SDY, though. Keeps things under control. At this point, Forza, they try to push up through Ivy, but they get scouted out. Almazari gets good through the wall, but actually, he connects with Jerry to find a kill onto the site. And now Dexter has so much to do, but Dexter comes alive at the moment that they need him most. Two kills, making this possible for SDY.
Oh, he would have loved that kill on the cross, but Onkare gets back to the safety of the train for him. He wants that kill, but he's not finding it. And now he might just have to get on the bomb. He's not going to be allowed to, though. Onkare. No Spirit are pushed in A main. They are really thinking it's going to be an A-sided play, and they might be right in that assessment. SDY's just found the first kill towards Pop Dog. Everyone from Spirit on this A site, and this becomes very scary for Forza. Flit gets the first kill, but Mir swings for the trade, and now it's Spirit with the man advantage, but Almaz has got something to say about that. MAC-10 comes out, he jumps back to safety. Oh god, this is not looking good for Forza. Another fight goes against them, and Spirit...
Forza into round number 20.
They want it all, and they want it now, Maui. Woro has something to say about that, though. Quick entry kill on the fast A main aggression. The rest of his team yet to follow him up, even though he's got that entry kill. Finally, though, Fools start to move out through A main, and Magix spots that man moving between the trains, but Jerry's already on the bomb train itself. Spirit not showing a massive amount of resistance here. Dexter caught off by so many players, but Magix has the chance to do something. Chopper gets another kill. It's back to a 2v.
No nades to work with, although Woro, he's keeping this Pop Dog position, and that might catch Spirit off. This is ECT at this point. This is just such an advanced position, and he's wrapping right behind them. And he's able to actually take down Magix because of it. Chopper, he smokes the bomb and actually is sticking it now. Almazer is trying to spray through the smoke, but he runs out of bullets, and Chopper is able to win that round.
He knew where it was positioned, but that slight positioning off of the bomb made all the difference. And this time, SDY gets aggressive onto A main. Two kills from that
position at this point. Jerry will look to make an aggressive play towards upper, but Dexter is just their force in the CIS region, and it's a reason that people have been really looking out for him. And SDY will capitalize on that missed flash. I think it was supposed to be a fake flash or a fake nade to try to make the player in ladder turn. It was a desperate attempt, I'll say that. And now Woro is taken down on top of that.
Really liking these fast out through A main plays with the early map control, the two smokes down. Pretty standard for teams to use these. Magic's again on this same angle with the AWP, lands an early shot. They're getting up close towards him though, that could be a problem. Dexter from above, that second AWP comes through. Finally, Magic's falls, but it's a man advantage extended upon by SDY. And this should be the game right here. Flip's got three players against him. Spots out that first man, trying to reposition, but he doesn't even have the bomb in his hands, and SDY closes it out. 16.